Oh, you.
I saw Daddy. Daddy's in. Hi, Dad.
Hi.
Hi. Hi, everybody. Hi, Nana.
Hi.
We have Meena. Hi, Rajesh.
Maybe this is
hi, hi. Mary, sisters, hi.
Hi.
Okay, we'll give another 5 minutes. New to everybody.
Alicia
and Ruben. No. Hi, how's everybody?
And
hi, Daddy.
Hi, Daddy.
We cannot hear you.
Jonathan,
don't touch anything.
He's muted.
No one's muted. Sit down.
This one is muted.
Hi, Dhruv. Okay, no problem. Wait, Jonathan, 1 second. Hi, Dhruv, it's very dark. All of us can, you can hear all of
hi,
us.
Hi, miss.
Hello.
Hi, pastor.
You cannot hear me. E7. I can, everybody can hear me?
Yes.
Okay, I think your audio now. You can hear me?
I think the sisters cannot hear.
Eugene. Check down the audio in your Okay. Dhruv is here. Hi. Anil. Anil is calling me. Hello. Yes. So do one thing, you know, log out and log in again. At the bottom of your screen, it says audio. Okay. Leave and then come back on the link. It will activate the audio. Tech support. And Mary and all, they can get audio. So they'll call back. Okay. So no worries, we are recording the session. And if you miss out anything, I will send that recording. Okay. So this session is getting recorded also. I think.
Wow, praise God.
Okay.
Yes. Yeah.
Okay. So I'm going to put all of us. Of course, we're going to pray and begin. I hope you have your elements ready at home. You can take biscuits. You can take bread, Pepsi, okay. This is just to do in memory of Jesus. So keep your communion elements ready. Okay. And after the word, we'll get into communion. Okay, and that will give time for some other people to join in. So your
headphones, yes.
So after we pray, I'm going to mute all of you, and then I'll unmute all of you. Okay. So, thank you for this time that we are together. Wonderful. We are online family. And thank you, Lord, for technology. Thank you, Lord, for your presence. In your word says, two or three are gathered in my name. There I am going. Lord, you are present right now. And thank you, Father, for your love. Lord, we come in the presence, Lord, of Jesus on this app. And we thank you that you are good. Amen.
Yes, amen.
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 Okay. Amen.
Okay. Good morning, church. This is our first time.
Good morning.
And so what I'm going to do is I'm just going to mute everybody. Is that okay? But if
yes.
There's an unmute button down, you know, so that we don't capture the house noises as you all we are at home and there are various noises. Okay, cool. Okay.
You sound good.
Okay. So I have muted everybody except myself. So you can hear me. And now we have less of the ambient noise coming around. This session is getting recorded. So if any of you miss anything, no worries. We will send it again on the YouTube channel. Okay. This is the Lord has been enabling in my heart to talk about the authority of the believer. You know, we are at this time where everything looks bad, good as we see it. However, when I was talking to the Lord and he said, you know, remind my people about themselves, about who they are. In this time, it's important that we establish ourselves in our identity. Okay. So I have sent the PDF on your WhatsApp, on our WhatsApp group. But no worries, we will still use the Bible and we will look through the verses. So the first verse that we will talk today about is 2 Corinthians 5:21. 2 Corinthians 5:21. Okay, I am happy to see most of you have your Bibles, digital, paper Bible, please get it. Don't worry about the time. We have this session for a very long time. God has enabled us to buy the membership for this session. So don't worry, it's not going to get over in 45 minutes. God is good. Amen. So it says in 2 Corinthians 5:21, what does it say? For he made him. God made Jesus, who knew no sin, to be sin for us, that we might become the righteousness of God in him. Let's read it once again. Read it in your Bibles. We all know this verse, very commonly used verse in our church at least. For he, that is God, made Jesus, who knew no sin. Jesus is and was and will always be sinless. He knew no sin, no sin. But God made Jesus to be sin for us. And here is the divine exchange that we might become. We are becoming. We might become the righteousness of God in him. All of you confess at your home, say, I am the righteousness of God in Christ. This is a very foundational verse that we have to stand on, that who you are. Say, I am the righteousness of God in Christ. Now, we'll look at this verse in the complete Jewish Bible. It's in your notes. You can read it later. God made this sinless man to be sin offering on our behalf, so that in union with him, we might fully share in God's righteousness. Fully share in God's righteousness. God always desired that we become like him. He made us in his image. He did not make us in the image of a tree or an animal or an angel. He chose himself to replicate. How wonderful. God chose himself to be replicated. That's why we are his righteousness. That is what we believe. We are his righteousness. We are his righteousness. Why am I stressing on this word that we are his righteousness? It is very, very important to know that we are his righteousness. The TPT says, for God made the only one, look at the word, only one who did not know sin to become sin for us. We are still in 2 Corinthians 5:21. For God made the only one who did not know sin to become sin for us, so that we who did not know righteousness, you know, before Jesus, you did not know righteousness. Without Jesus, you do not know righteousness. On your own, you don't know righteousness. Right? Righteousness, so that we who did not know righteousness might become the righteousness of God through our union with him. Say, I have the authority. I am the righteousness of Christ. Amen. Amen. Let us go to Isaiah 54, verse 14 to 17. Isaiah 54, verse 14 to 17. Okay, it's all there. Isaiah 54, verse 14 to 17. Okay. Happy to see you all with your Bibles. In righteousness, you shall be established. This is what it says. In righteousness, you shall be established. In what you should be established? In righteousness. In nothing else but righteousness. We just came from 2 Corinthians 5:21 saying, I am the righteousness of God in Christ. And it is very, very, very important to establish yourself. To establish yourself. You know, these companies, they have the, on their letter, established in 19 so and so, established in 2014, established. That is when they were planted. That is when the foundation was laid. Your foundation is in this, that you are established. You are established in righteousness. There it is. In righteousness, you shall be established. Nowhere else. You shall be far from oppression. You shall not fear. When you are established in this identity that I am the righteousness of God, fear is far away. See, when you are not established, you are fearful. You are wondering, where am I? Who am I? Who am I? This is the question that always the enemy is asking, who are you? Right? So, in this verse, it says, in righteousness you shall be established. You shall be far from oppression. You shall not fear. That is what is roaming around. Fear and oppression. The enemy wants to put fear and oppression, but not to you. Cannot come near you. Because you are established in righteousness. Right? Indeed, they shall surely assemble, but not because of me. Whoever assembles against you shall fall for your sake. When you are established in righteousness, there is no enemy that can assemble against you. Nobody can form against you when you are established in righteousness. Behold, I have created the blacksmith who blows the coals in the fire, who brings forth an instrument of his work. I have created the spoiler to destroy. No weapon formed against you shall prosper. Here the Lord is saying the destroyer he knows. The destroyer he knows. But verse 17 says no weapon. No weapon. Tell your neighbor no weapon. Tell your neighbor. Turn to your neighbor. If you don't have a neighbor, you can tell me no weapon. No weapon. No weapon formed against you shall prosper. Don't get scared of weapons that are forming. Don't get scared of weapons that are forming. You don't need to get scared because they will not prosper. they will not bring to, they will not come to fruition where they are supposed to be, right? No weapon against you shall prosper. And this verse is, you know, another Bible verse we use half. We say, no weapon against us shall prosper. We are all excited and we tell it to each other, no weapon, no weapon. Yeah, yeah, yes, I'm with you. But I want you to go to the later half of this verse. Read the verse totally. No weapons against you shall prosper, and every tongue which rises against you in judgment. Yes, every tongue. Anybody who is speaking against you, every tongue which rises against you in judgment. What does the next verse say? God shall condemn? No. You. Point to yourself. I can see all of you all. Say, point to yourself. Yeah. Say, this is the you. Say, I shall condemn. I shall condemn. Don't wait for God to condemn these things. He has given you the authority. Don't sit back and agree with the world. You know what is to condemn? In your notes, I have put the meaning. To officially declare something to be unfit for use. You have the authority to declare what's outside that you are unfit. As an official of God, you have the righteousness of God. Use your authority and say, it's unfit. It's not right. You cannot come near me. You know what? Whatever the news channel shares, it's okay to read and then say, I condemn this in Jesus' name. It's in your mouth. The prosperity of that weapon is in your mouth. The weapons are being formed, and amen, let them be formed. But your mouth will desist from prosperity of the enemy's weapon. Here I am here to tell you, don't sit and agree with the news. Don't sit at home in this lockdown and go on reading the news, but read what is your rights. Stand on your bill of rights. You know, in righteousness you shall be established. In righteousness you shall be established. Don't use this verse halfway and just be happy about the weapon not prospering. It is only going to come to pass when you shall contend. This is the heritage of the servants of the Lord. This is the heritage of the servants of the Lord. You know, the word heritage is, I've made it, marked it in your notes when you read it, a special possession, an allotted option. This is a special right you have as a child of God. You know, it comes from the word inheritance. As the son of the father, and as your father's son, I would rather say, as the father's son, use that right and say to that thing that is outside, you shall not prosper. I know who my daddy is. I know who my father is. I know who I am. I use his rights and I say, you shall not prosper. Don't succumb to this like mere mortal. You are not a mere mortal. You are the son of the living God. His very life is inside of you. I didn't mean to preach so hard, but praise God, it's coming all out of me. You know, the Amplified on the same verse, verse 14 says, you shall establish yourself in righteousness. The Amplified AMPC verse 14, Isaiah 54 verse 14 says, you shall establish yourself. Psalm 1 says, the righteous is planted. Establish yourself. Plant yourself. Take a stand, as Ephesians 6 says. Stand. Establish yourself. You know, when you look at an old company that has been there for many years, you know when it is established, you know that is the time it was planted. That's the time where it started. You do the same thing. Establish yourself in righteousness. You know, 2 Corinthians 5:21 is a nuclear bomb that you have. It says that you have the same rights that God has. I am the righteousness of God. That means I have the rights that God has in Christ Jesus. God used his rights, and when he saw darkness, said light. You use your right, and when you see this darkness outside, you say, let there be light. Let there be life. You declare it. You go ahead and condemn this thing that is not worthy to stay here. Amen. The TPT in your Bible, in your notes, it says on the verse 17, but I promise you, I'm going to read it for you, listen, but I promise you, no weapon meant to hurt you will succeed. There it is. That is what God has promised. No weapon meant to hurt you. Weapons are formed. That's the work of the blacksmith. Let him do his work. Your work as the son of God, who is a servant also, is to condemn that weapon. Don't let it form. But I promise you, no weapon meant to hurt you will succeed. And you will refute. You know, means refute is to say condemn. No. You will refute every accusing word spoken against you. This promise is the inheritance of Yahweh's servant. For their vindication, for their righteousness is from me, says Yahweh. Again, the Lord closes Isaiah 54 from saying, the righteousness, that his righteousness is yours. Let's read the New King James Version on the 17. No weapon formed against you shall prosper. And every tongue which rises against you in judgment, you shall condemn. This is the heritage of the servants of the Lord. And what the Lord says, and their righteousness is from me. Say, my righteousness is from the Lord. My righteousness is from the Lord. You know, it's very nice when you say this word, is my righteousness is from the Lord, is you don't need to do anything to earn it. You don't need to do anything to earn it. You have to establish yourself that you are his righteousness. Establish yourself that you are his righteousness. Establish yourself you are his righteousness in Christ. Whatever happens, this is the truth. That I am the righteousness of God in Christ. Well, you may say that's the Old Testament. Let's go to New Testament. Let's go to Matthew 18, 18 to 20. Let's go to Matthew 18, 18, 20. If you open your Bible, when you open your Bible and as your Bibles are open, you will notice that these words are in red. These words are in red. So everybody in their Bibles, see, this is what Jesus is saying. Assuredly. And assuredly can be also said as amen. Assuredly. I say to you. Jesus is saying to you. Assuredly. I say to you. Whatever you bind. Point to yourself again. All of you point to yourself again. Say you. Mere bare mein baat kar rahe. Say you, he's talking about me. Come on, point to yourself. You, come on, it's you. Even Judah, even Samuel, even Joel. Say you. Very good. Whatever you bind on earth, whatever you bind on earth. Jesus is telling whatever you bind on earth. This is your Lord and Savior, your Master. Jesus is your Lord. Yes, he is. That's why we all Christians. And what is your Lord saying? You bind on earth. Right? Whatever, what is the Lord saying? You bind on earth. Correct? Whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven. Heaven does not need anything to be bound. Nobody can attack Jesus in heaven. Nobody can attack the angels in heaven. There is no virus, coronavirus in heaven. Amen? There's no coronavirus. There's no nothing there. There's no lag. There's no death. It's here on planet earth. So what the Lord said, look, you're my son, you're my brother, right? As my brother, what you do, whatever you bind, whatever is a very nice word, is whatever can be whatever. There is no limit. You need something to be bound, bind it. Something troubling you, unnecessarily, bind it. Something eating up your peace, you bind it. You're the police officer with the handcuffs. Bind it up. Don't say, Lord, bind it. Lord said, the handcuff is with you. The handcuff is with you, not with me. Right? If you don't believe this, read the end of Matthew. It says, all authority has been given to me. Now, therefore, you go. Right? So, the handcuff is with you. Whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven. You know what? What you bind on earth, heaven agrees with you and binds it. Says the Son of God, says, bind kya jai. If the Son of God binds, you bind. Right? Whatever you bind in, what needs to be bound? This virus? Yes. In the name of Jesus, in the authority given to us, we all agree and we bind it in Jesus' name. Whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven. Whatever you loose on earth, whatever you loose, in the name of Jesus, we loose the vaccine in Jesus' name. We loose prosperity in Jesus' name. We'll be loose on earth. Whatever you lose on earth will be loosed in heaven. Again, I say to you, if two of you agree, know, the Lord spoke to me in the morning. He kept telling me, is tell my people of the power of agreement. Tell my people of the power of, stop fighting with other Christians and other believers on doctrine and all that. Stop fighting. Agree with them. If they believe in the name of Jesus, agree with them, because there is power. If you agree, the Lord loves us to agree, because he agrees with his Father. Again, I say to you, if two of you, he needs only two. Only two. And if you have nobody, Jesus is your other two. He says, I be with you, right? So Jesus is your other two. If you have nobody to agree with, guess what? Who is there to agree with you? Jesus is there. Say, Jesus, I say amen to you. And there he is there to agree with you. If two of you agree on earth concerning anything, again, concerning anything. Is anything anything? Yes. Does anything have a definition? No. Anything is anything. Can be big, small, whatever. Whatever is your anything, God is interested in it. That they ask, it will be done for them. It will be done for them by my Father in heaven. When we agree, the Father gets to work. When we agree, the Father gets to work. When we agree, the Father. So I see many of you sitting. So turn to your neighbor and say, I agree with you. Come on. Say, I agree with you. I agree with you. Come on. Start agreeing in your families. It's okay. You're all there together in the lockdown to agree with one another on anything. Agree on anything. You know, it is about doing the dishes. Agree with one another. It's about washing the clothes. Agree with one another. It is about making the food. Agree with one another. Right? If two of you agree on earth concerning anything that they ask, it will be done for them by my Father. You agree and the Father does. Look at the verse again. You agree and the Father does. All he needs is your agreement, because without your agreement, oh, the Father cannot do. Converse of this verse, right? If you do not agree, if two of you do not agree, if you do not even agree with Jesus, how can the Father do? Because you're saying no to Jesus. You know what? When you agree with some buddies in your house who's a Christian, you're actually agreeing with Jesus. You know, from the youngest on this video to the oldest, everybody has Jesus. To the youngest Judah out there, to the oldest Nana there, everybody has Jesus. So when you agree with them, you're agreeing with Jesus, right? Don't look at them in their physical form. Say, hey, Jesus is in them and I agree with them. And I agree with them, right? See, when you agree, then the Father says, I'm getting into action. Sit back. It's my time. All he needs is your yes. You say, I agree with you, Father. And he steps into action. Look at it. This is what the verse says. This is in the Bible. This is not me. I've not written this. This is Jesus written. You have anything against this word, take it up with Jesus. Again, for verse 20. For where two or three are gathered together in my name. Two or three are gathered together in my name. I am the great I am from Exodus. I am there in the midst of them. As we agree together as Christians, as sons of the living God, you know, family agrees. It is okay to, you know, sometimes we can have arguments, but at the end of the day, agree. At least agree on the word of God. Agree with each other saying, Jesus is in this other person. I may not like the opinion as of today, but Jesus is in that other. Jesus, help me to agree. You know, he's even there to help you to agree. I am here to tell you, you don't need to use your effort. If you cannot agree with somebody, it's okay, who is a believer. Say, Jesus, help me to agree with this person. If you want me to agree, help me, Jesus. You can ask his help. And if nobody is there in your house to agree with you, don't worry. Jesus is with you. You know, the best person to agree with is Jesus. All you say, amen to his words, and the Father gets into action. Amen. I want to read the same verse from the Amplified, AMPC. Truly, I tell you, Jesus says, whatever you forbid and declare to be improper and unlawful on earth must be already forbidden in heaven, and whatever you permit and declare proper and lawful on earth must be what already permitted in heaven. Whatever you forbid and declare to be improper, it's up to you. That is what is the binding about. What you see improper in your life, don't agree with it, bind it. Agree with Jesus and bind it in Jesus' name. Because what? The authority is with you. When you agree, the Father gets to work and helps you. Amen. I will read the last verse. It says in the Message version, take this most seriously. Take this most seriously. Message version, Matthew 18:20 is in the notes. If you open the PDF, take this most seriously. A yes on earth is a yes in heaven. A yes on earth is a yes in heaven. Every time you say yes on earth is a yes in heaven. Heaven is waiting for your yes and amens. I'm going to say it again. Heaven is waiting for your yes and amen. You don't wait for heaven. You say yes, and heaven is waiting for that yes. And a no on earth is a no in heaven. When you say no to something, it's a no in heaven. What you say to one another is eternal. What you say to one another is eternal. I mean this. When two of you get together or anything at all on earth and make a prayer of it, when two of you get together on anything on earth and make a prayer of it, two of you agree, let's do this in Jesus' name, my Father in heaven goes into action. My Father, Jesus said, my Father, and now he is our Father, goes into action. My Father in heaven goes into action. My Father in heaven goes into action. You know, it's very exciting to know that based on our agreement, the Father goes into action. If you find there's nothing happening in your life, check your agreement. Check where you're established. An establishing works on agreement. Every establishment has an agreement. All the people who are running businesses will know this. You know, when you join an establishment, you sign an offer letter. That means you're agreeing to that establishment. Without an agreement, you are not established. You cannot use the rights of that establishment. The Father established you in his righteousness, and now he just wants you to agree with him and your brothers. Agree with them together. Don't sit disputing, oh, this and that. Just say, come, let's just agree in the name of Jesus and kick this improper, unlawful thing on our planet in Jesus' name. Get violent about it. You have the power. As I said, you have the handcuffs to bind, and you have the key to release. It's in your hand. That's why Jesus said in Matthew 18:20. That's why Jesus said in Matthew 18:20. And when two or three of you are together because of me, you can be sure that I'll be there. You know, you can be sure that I'll be there. When two or three are there together, you know, be sure. I want to leave us with 2 Corinthians 5:21 again. I want to read from the TPT once again. For God made 2 Corinthians 5:21. It's on the top of your notes. For God made the only one who did not know sin to become sin for us. Stop thinking that you are a sinful person. Stop thinking you are a sinful person. Stop it in Jesus' name. You are no longer a sinner. Jesus became your sin. Now you are the righteousness of God. This is what happens is when you see these verses, the enemy keeps telling you you're a sinner. The Lord may brought me back to 2 Corinthians 5:21 right now. He says to all of us, you know, sometimes you say, how can I bind? You know what? I am not a good person. La, 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 la. That's all rubbish. Right? Don't sit and wallowing in self-pity and say, oh, you don't know my past. You don't know what I did. You don't know who I am. You don't know I did this. And Jesus is not concerned about all that. He's not concerned. He's not concerned about all that. As per 2 Corinthians 5:21, Jesus became sin who knew no sin, so that you who did not know righteousness are as of today, right now, this very minute, on 5th April 2020, 11:09 a.m., you are the righteousness of God. Tomorrow you will be the righteousness of God. Till Jesus comes, you will be the righteousness of God. Yesterday you were the righteousness of God. Whatever you say and do does not change his righteousness. Why? It's based on Jesus. Why? Because it's based on Jesus. Your righteousness is not based on you. It is based on Jesus. Now, basis that right, you can go in Isaiah 54, 14, 17. You can go to Matthew 18, 18, 20. Basis this right. I am the righteousness of God. That's why I condemn this. I am the righteousness of God. That's why I bind and loose. I am the righteousness of God. That's why I agree with Jesus. He does not see my sin. The Father does not see my sin. Nobody sees my sin. I don't need to see my sin. You don't have any sin. The sin has been crucified on the cross of Calvary. So stop thinking about sin and this and oh, people are sinning and that's why this is happening. It's all rubbish. Don't think. Jesus did not come into the world to condemn the world. One more verse. John 3:17. We all know John 3:16. John 3:17. John 3:17. Everybody there? Okay, great. Please open your Bibles. Please open, see the word of God. You know, the word of God brings light. The entrance of his word brings light. You know, when there's no word in your life, you are dark about, you have no light, you have no revelation of who you are. That is what the enemy wants to not. Open your Bible and read, right? What it says in John 3:17. For God did not send his son into the world to condemn the world. God did not send Jesus Christ to condemn. You know, we just saw the meaning of condemn, to declare unworthy, to declare unfit, to declare not fit. Jesus did not come to declare the people in this world unfit. So don't think that John 3:17 has gone away. Jesus is not this. This virus is not from God. And if you are thinking about it, please change this. Don't think that way. This is not condemnation of God on the people. Right? Why would God change in 2020 when he wrote this verse in John 3:17? Nothing changes with God. God said, I am the same yesterday, today and forever. So John 3:17, Jesus did not come to condemn the world. He did not come to say that anybody is unfit. He came with a choice. You know, if the world is getting condemned, it is their choice. But Jesus is not condemning them. No. For God did not send his son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. Jesus, the salvation of the world. The salvation of the world is in you. You are the brothers of Jesus. Just as Jesus, do not condemn the world, but now show them their salvation. Whatever is happening outside, tell them Jesus loves them. Tell them, and I want to tell you, Jesus loves you. I want to say the Father loves you. You are loved. Amen. Amen. I'm going to unmute all of us. And that is what the Lord has put in my heart to share with you. Tell you, God loves you. God
Amen.
Loves you. Come on, say to yourself, God loves me.
God loves me.
Jesus loves me.
God loves me.
Jesus loves me.
I am loved.
I am loved.
I am loved.
I am loved. I am
loved. Yes, please feel on this. I am loved.
I am loved.
Amen.
Amen.
I hope
you are ready. Hallelujah.
Do you have your communion element ready?
classes at home?
Yes.
At home.
At home.
We have the wine. So this is wine. I have Pepsi in the house.
I am love.
And I have Mari biscuit. So all of you are there in wine. Bread, patty, whatever you have in the house. I can see that you whatever you have, you can have to get glasses of water, so that's fine.
Salvio is there, see, I told you, mommy and all are there sitting on the sofa.
Yes. Thank you. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Okay, we are going to.
Nana.
We are going to pray. Jesus said, do this in remembrance of me. So when you're having this bread, remember Jesus. Remember you are the righteousness of God. Remember the loving kindness of Jesus. He's your friend. He said, I am their brother. Remember John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his son. Remember love. You're going to have this as love. You're going to have this confessing on yourself. You're going to have this confessing on yourself. I am loved. Hold this bread in your hands. And say to yourself, I am loved. You can tell your family, you're loved. You know, you're loved with such a great love. You know, 1 John 3:1 says, for such wonderful love he has bestowed on us. Behold, what manner of love the Father has bestowed on us, that we should be called the children of God. We should be called the children of God. Behold, what manner of love the Father has bestowed on us, that we should be called the children of God. So even as you break this bread, you know, Jesus' body was broken. So you break it. You break it. Jesus was broken. So you are whole. This is your health. This is your protection. You're eating Jesus. Okay. Now you can take part of the bread. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for you were broken, you were chastised for my peace. The chastisement of my peace was upon him, and by his stripes we are healed. By his stripes we are healed. By his stripes we are healed. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. This is the wine. Jesus said, this is the blood of the new covenant. New covenant. You know, in the new covenant, God says in Hebrews chapter 8, I'll just go there. I'll read it from my Bible. Even as you take part of the wine, I just want to show you the new covenant. This is the new covenant. He says in Hebrews 8 verse 12, I'm reading part of it. I will be merciful to their unrighteousness and their sins and their lawless deeds. I will remember no more. This is what is the new covenant. God says, I will be merciful, full of mercy to their unrighteousness. It's okay, whatever you're going through, remember, you have, when you have this cup, remember, I have a merciful God. I have a merciful God. He is merciful to our unrighteousness and their sins and lawless deeds. Whatever sins, whatever, He says, I will remember no more. He chooses not to remember. He uses his will not to remember. So please, you also do not remember. You know, when you talk about your sins, it's you alone talking. God does not remember. He says, what sin? He really says, what sin? Second, 1 Peter 2:24 talks about it. Our sins are on the body of Jesus. So when you look at this cup, tell yourself, my sins and my lawless deeds. Father remembers no more. I am forgiven. So I remember my sins no more. I am free from sin consciousness. I am free from sin consciousness. Not have the wine.
It's a Alina.
You can talk to each other.
Testimony.
Daddy, you want to say something? We can hear you. Pastor Eugene. Pastor Eugene. Can't hear you, Daddy.
What is it? Give my phone.
Somebody's phone is ringing. Anybody wants to share some testimony?
What is this to do?
How's everybody? Nice to see your faces.
Pastor sir is on live now, online.
Hi, Daddy. Hi. We can hear mommy.
Hi, everybody.
Hi, all.
Praise the Lord, we love you. You are a blessing. Praise everything.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.